Well, that's it, I'm out again early, well, early-ish, on a Sunday morning. We're setting out on a 100 mile loop. We're gonna do nice and steady and slow. 50 mile today, with an overnight camp tonight. 50 mile tomorrow. I got Tony in front, there he is, look. He's the birthday boy. It's his birthday tomorrow. Another cyclist coming in, look. Morning. Yeah, we've got to meet up with Dave. He's in a neighbouring village. And then we're setting off. Our journey takes us up onto the Ridgeway, along the Ridgeway to Goring-on-Thames, where we pick up the Thames path. Follow the Thames path down to Reading, where we pick up the Avon and Kennet Canal, and then all the way along the towpath of the canal to Marlborough, which part we go through or pass through Thatcham, Newbury, Kintbury. So it'd be a beautiful ride. And then when we get to Marlborough, we get on the old defunct railway track, and we cycle back home again. A total of 100 mile. It's Dave's neighbour, look. Anyway, Dave's got a new bike. We'll have a look at that in a minute. We'll have a look at that bike a little later on, Dave.
All right, well, you're getting onto the Ridgeway and looking at it.
We'll follow you to the Ridgeway. That's my trademark. Well, not that it can be trademarked, as Dave was saying, because it's over 2,000 years old. Anyway, we're climbing Ashbury Hill. Here we are, just coming up onto the Ridgeway now. We turn left here, and then it's all off-road now. It's all off-road now till we get to Goring or Streatley on Thames, where we pick up the Thames path. Just along here, it's the ancient Neolithic long barrow at Wayland Smithy, and whenever I cycle up past this way, I always call in. You bought yourself a nice smart new bike then, Dave?
Yes, treated myself for my 60th birthday, son.
Let's have a look at it then.
And I had some gift vouchers and some money, so I thought, well, you've been on at me for a long time to get a bike that I can do certain rides with you.
Doing the King Arthur's way soon, aren't we, Dave?
we can't get out of it now, hopefully.
No, they can't, no. Sometimes you've got to commit to something and just get on and do it. So Dave's bought this lovely new bike. It's a Decathlon Riverside 520. Is it 520?
520.
And he's got it all tricked out. The good thing with it, it actually comes with a dynamo hub, disc brakes. It's got, not brazed ons, but additions to allow.
It's got about 34 bosses on there, I think, for connecting bottle racks and all sorts on there.
Yeah.
So. And a stout rack on the back as
So he's got it all kitted out. He's put a kickstand on it so it stands up. He's got loads of stuff on it. Well tricked out, Dave. That's a nice bike, isn't it?
Pleased with it so far, Sandy.
Haven't been anywhere on it yet, have you?
I suppose I've done about 100 miles all told on it, I suppose.
Yeah. What do you reckon then, Tony, that bike then?
Nice.
Yeah. You're the boy.
For money, I think it's a good bike. Yeah. I mean, obviously, you know.
And these days,
ideally, I'd like a steel bike with a roll-off hub and all that. But I mean, you're talking thousands then, aren't you? Yeah. But for sort of value for money.
Yeah. The good thing about it, Dave, is that rack, how it bolts on to the chain, well, not the chain stay, seat stay, and it can take 40 kilos, isn't it?
44 kilos it's rated.
44 kilos, that's rated at 44 kilos.
The wheels will take the weight and the rider, I don't know.
Well, I expect so. I expect it will.
I jacked out the mud guards a little bit. I put some little bracket on there just to throw them off the tyres a bit more, give it a bit more clearance.
Triggers Broom. It's the same frame, but it's got how many different sets of wheels, Tone?
All right, so that's his third set of wheels.
So yeah, a decent bike, don't it?
Yeah, it's 32 now, 32 years old.
He's 32 years old. Look, he's got a charged spoon as well, that's what I'm riding on. Lovely saddle that, Dave, isn't it, Dave?
Not for me, no, I didn't get on with him. I've got one in my shed, you can have it if you want it.
I'm enjoying the low gear ratios on my Bootzipper. It makes some of the steeper hills fairly easy to climb. We're just coming up now next to Uffington Hill 4. Total distance since leaving home, 12.9 miles. Watch it when it's downhill, your bike can run away with you.
You don't want that.
No.
This is where I broke my last rear wheel.
Oh, really?
Yeah. I was riding down here and I thought, oh, what's that clicking sound? And it was the rim of the wheel peeling away from the underneath the brake. You know, and every time it went past the brake, the rim would just go clack, 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 clack. Oh. Right. Oh.
I'm thinking.
I'm going to take it steady along here.
Wait.
Just up passing Sparsholt Firs now, so we're at 15.5 mile mark since leaving home. Sparsholt Firs is. It's got. A radio mast. So we used to, when I used to fly paramotors, we used to use that as a meeting point. We'd fly our paramotors and then circle above the mast and meet the other pilots, and then we go off on our little adventures. So that's where we are, Sparsholt Firs. Such a lot of nice views. Just behind, just over my left hand shoulder, that's the Devil's Punch Bowl. Don't think you can see it very well because of the foliage. Devil's Punch Bowl. Just again over my left hand shoulder is Segsbury Camp, which is another sort of ring ditch enclosure. You can't see it very well through the thick hedge, mind, but it's definitely there. Best way to see it, of course, is a drone shot. So that's Segsbury Camp. We're at 18.7 miles. Again, a lovely view over my left hand shoulder looking north. Of course, all the views are going to be over the left hand shoulder when you're progressing along the Ridgeway from the, I guess, a west to east direction. Just stopped at Lord Wantage's monument. Apparently this monument was built on a Neolithic tumuli. Again, there we got lovely views all around. We're now cycling past Skirchimer's Knob at 23.5 miles. Whoop, bloody hell. 23.5 miles from leaving home this morning, so we're almost a quarter of the way through the ride. And that's Skirchimer's Knob over there. Well, we're just crossing underneath the A34, one of the main roads to Oxford, and this is where you'll find lots of very old Neolithic cave paintings. Appreciating the low climbing gears on the Bootzipper, I must admit that was a stiff climb back there, but it's all downhill now into Streatley. Here we are at Goring on Thames. So we've now gone past Goring and Streatley, and we're actually on the Thames path now. You can't quite see it, but over to my right, not far away, is River Thames. We've got an obstacle, a tree down. You can see the river just through the trees there. You want a hand, Dave?
Yeah, give us a hand.
Hang on, I'll give you a hand.
Give us a hand.
One, two.
I forgot Tony's bike's got 26 inch wheels.
Go and put your bike safe.
Hold up.
You can
also only weigh 25
pounds. Right, after three. One, two, three.
It's in
brilliant. What's all this down here, Dave?
The water.
Whew. This is a hard hill. No way could you cycle up that. Well, unless you're super fit, of course. That's the Hartley Steps. So there you go. What do you reckon to that then?
That's a walking step, isn't it?
You couldn't cycle that, could you?
No, I couldn't, no.
Not even on an unencumbered bike, couldn't go up that.
It's hard work, that. Hartley Steps. Approximately 43 miles, and we're just making it into Reading. There's a couple of little ships, little boats down here, and apparently these two were little vessels. These were on the Dunkirk little ship, historical evacuation, if you like. There you go. I know that because Mr. Hawkins went down there and chatted to the guy for about half an hour whilst we were eating our ice creams. Very cosmopolitan along here. Restaurants on the left and the Kennet and Avon, I think, on the right. Outside Reading now, and it's beautiful, peaceful and tranquil, I'm glad to say, although we are heading into a bit of a headwind now. Lovely long here. I've got the canal on my right and I've got a lovely water meadow on my left, and we got to wind ourselves along here for about 30 odd mile, and it's all level and flat. Got to film this. That's the M4, the horrible busy road. Anyway, it links Bristol to London, but we're on the quiet cycle track next to it, and we're coming away from the M4 now, thank goodness, and heading back towards the canal. This is one of the, it's all bolted up, one of the pillboxes. Yeah, it's all been sealed, you can't get into it. That's a shame. Next to a lock. We're around about the 50 mile mark now. Just met this lovely chap, he's telling us about his life on the canal boat.
Yeah. Wouldn't change it.
Yeah.
Wouldn't change
just
it.
Just admiring your garden on the roof there, it's lovely.
Yeah.
Put mine to shame.
Tomatoes on the front.
Yeah. Tomato, right.
Well, this lovely place is Tyne Mill Lock. And we're going to stop here. It's now just about 6 o'clock in the evening. We're going to stop here. We're going to make something to eat. Maybe stay for half hour. And then press on for another hour and a half and try and find somewhere to camp. I got my lovely old pocket rocket. I bought this, this is about 16 years old, this one.
Because this one's got a built-in wind
shield. Sort of a built-in wind shield. Sort of. Dave's got the old trans here, look.
I should think it's 40 years old, Sam, and it's been used about 10 times.
Yeah, well, you'll be using it a lot more now, I reckon.
Look at the bottom of my lid, look, compared to yours.
Yeah, they are.
I do wash mine up, which is more than you ever do.
Mine's never been washed, Dave. Never. Tony's got a Trans-Ear triangle, which I give him.
Hey! Nothing better than a freebie.
Oh, that's right.
That's handled, Sam.
Oh yeah, I got some more e-bikes coming. These are ladies' versions. My wife Mandy's going to have one of them. She found the Hemiway bike a bit heavy, so I got a lightweight e-bike coming for her. And another friend's going to get one as well. So it's good to share the love. Half past seven almost. We've done 56.4 mile and we think we're going to camp here, just over there. That's where the canal is. In fact, someone's got, you can see the towpath. I don't think we're going to get a better spot, really. Oh, this will do. We're all going to crawl into our respective shelters. Tony's roughing it in a bivvy bag.
I ain't roughing it, I'm toughing it. Alright.
Anyway, sleep well. Dave's in the Jack Wolf skin, which is similar to the snowpack ionosphere, a cheaper version. And I'm not quite sure, but I think it's possibly a better tent. Impressive that one, Dave.
Very pleased with it, Sandy.
He's very pleased with
it. Thank my sister for that and my friends Lorna, Bob and Harry.
Oh, well done.
For giving me Amazon vouchers, which I used to purchase it with.
Yeah.
If you notice, because Mr. Jack hasn't got the foresight to bring a padlock, I'm having to padlock my bike to his.
Good job.
It will be if they'll reach.
Right, and then lastly, I'm in the snug pack ionosphere. So I'm gonna crawl in there like I do with it. I'm getting a bit tired now. See you in the morning. Good morning, everybody. That was a nice pitch last night. I slept quite well. Yeah, back onto the back onto the towpath of the canal now. Yeah, right next to the canal. Nice pitch. Put the drone up and had a look round. A nice peaceful camp last night. It's been really good up to now, hasn't it? Yeah. So long here. Yeah, but oh dear, look at this look. This has just come down by the looks of it. That has just come down. Well, as you can see, we're not following the towpath at the moment. The tree was blocking the towpath and we couldn't get through. That's the only problem with riding on the canal network. If there is a blockage, it's generally turn around and find an alternative route. So that's what we've done. We hope to rejoin the canal a bit further on. Well, we're back on the canal again now on the towpath. Incidentally, this is National Cycle Network Route 4, and we're about 5 miles away from Newbury, where we're stopping for coffee. Past that Jimena apparently, but that's there's a lock there, and that's the height of the canal here. And by comparison, if I pan round to the right, you'll see the height of the river. Oh, we made it to Newbury, where we're going to come off the route at some point and get ourselves a coffee. Victoria Park.
Right.
Quiet.
Gotta do that.
I got it on film though.
Thank you.
It's an overloaded bicycle.
Yeah.
It's an awkward position to film over the gate.
Jim Dobry! Yak Shimash!
Dobbs!
Dobbs are doing, couldn't you? I think we're in Hungerford. Hungerford, yeah?
I'm pretty sure it's Hungerford.
So at this stage we say farewell to Mike. He's on his way across the country on his bike. And hopefully we'll see you again at some point, Mike.
We had on one. But it's there. It is there again. It's there.
Yep.
Well, the weather's changing for the worse and we're in the grounds of Little Coat House now, so cycling against the traffic. So hopefully this will bring us out near Chilton Foliot, and then we're going to pick up Chopping Knife Lane and go into Marlborough that way. We're going to the last coffee stop shop. God, it's proved to be quite an expensive ride, this. All these flipping coffee stops. Anyway, they're nice. They are nice. And this is a really nice coffee shop.
Very nice.
And then I'll say steak and chips.
Happy birthday, Tone.
All right, thank you.
So there you go, Tony's birthday. And we're in Marlborough. We haven't got far to go now, so probably going to wind the video up here. So for myself, Dave and Tony, thanks for watching and we'll see you on the next one. Bye for now.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Don't forget, say hello to Tony, say happy birthday to Tony in the comments. I'm sure he'll love that. He reads all the comments.
I do occasionally when I'm in them.
Got your long